The further you get from the center of the halls, the more distinct the shows are from each other. Because inside the halls, we have certain beliefs about what works. You need to have seating. You need to have flow between the galleries. So we're pretty strict in terms of how we build the halls. When you get outside, you really feel the city that you're in. You know, Miami is very much vamos a la playa. Basel is one of the great cultural capitals and has been for centuries. It's a medieval city that has grown into the modern age. Hong Kong, on the other hand, is one of the real cosmopolises, and you really feel that. You feel that it's a melting spot where people from all over the world meet with each other and do business with each other. The highlight for Hong Kong would be the Alpha Pulse performance by Carsten Nicolai. You know, the idea that Art Basel could take over one of the largest buildings in the world and transform it into an artwork for 50 minutes, three nights in a row, is breathtaking. And the performance was everything we could have hoped for and more. I mean, it was really one of those things that you'll never forget. My highlight from Basel would really have to be 14 Rooms, an unparalleled event in the history of live art. 14 Rooms was a project we did at the Beiler Foundation and the Basel Theater, in which Hans-Ulrich Obrist and Klaus Biesenbach curated 14 projects where the artist created a room, and each of them had to create an artwork which involved living people, but it was not the artists themselves. So what was really interesting was the range of approaches that people had to this. In one case, Dominique Gonzalez-Forster, actually, it was the viewer themselves, in the sense that they walked in and closed the door, and there was no handle. So they were locked in there until someone else opened the door. It was a really, really interesting experiment with magnificent architecture by Herzog and Demeron. So we really were very lucky to have that. And it was an extension of a piece that had taken place in other places. This was, I think, the largest scale of this ever. My highlight for Miami is actually the whole show itself, which sounds like cheating, but the fact is that a show is composed of many, many parts. And this is a show where really there are no weak links. I think this is a show where many of the efforts we've made for many years to increase the quality of certain things, to work on certain galleries, to do their best, has really come to fruition. And I think I saw this already on Tuesday night when I walked around before the show opened. You got the sense that this was a show of extreme quality. This was a show where people had either gotten consignments from collectors or commissioned pieces from their artists at the highest level possible. And the great thing is that not only does the show look great, but also the patrons, the collectors, the museum directors have seen that, and it's been a great show for the gallerists as well. And as a result, they're going into the end of the year with a great feeling about being gallerists. I think the most distinctive event was Meme for Miami, a production which was originally commissioned by Performa in New York as part of last year's Performa Biennial, which we then brought and adapted to Miami. Ryan created a much more Miami version of it, much more tropical, sensual version. And what was really interesting about it was also the space it took place in, which was the former Playboy Theater. As a rule, we never talk about what we're going to do until we do it. But I think we can be certain that next March in 2015 in Hong Kong, we will see, in a sense, a second debut for the Hong Kong show, because until now, the May dates meant that there were a lot of great Western galleries and a lot of great Western collectors that couldn't come. And yet now, at this fair in Miami Beach, I've heard a lot of people saying, I'm coming, for the first time I'm coming, where do I need to stay? And so in a weird way, in the third year of its existence, 5 years after we bought it, this will be a global debut for a lot of people, for the Hong Kong show and for Hong Kong as a cultural city.